Hello and welcome to the fourth section of this course. In this section, we'll talk about integral numbers. In C#, there are two main categories of numeric data types: integral numbers and floating point numbers. Integral numbers are used to represent whole numbers, such as 1, 2, 3. On the other hand, floating point numbers are used to represent decimal values, such as 3.14 or pi number, which we'll talk about in detail in the next section. Alright, now let's check the data types diagram that we showed you in the previous lectures. As you can see, value types are divided into several categories. One of them is simple type. Simple types are predefined by the C# and are used to store simple values. And in this lecture, we wanna talk about a category of these types, which is integral numbers. C# provides several types for storing integral numbers, such as sbyte, short, int, long, and nint, which are signed numbers, and byte, uSHORT, uInt, uLong, and nUInt, which are unsigned numbers. Each of these number types has a memory size and a range of values they can represent. As you can see, signed number types represent both positive and negative values, while unsigned number types only represent positive values. For example, sbyte and byte have a size of 8 bits, but they differ in the range of values they can hold. The sbyte can hold values between -128 and 127, while the byte can hold values between 0 and 255. Other number types, such as short and uSHORT, int and uInt, long and uLong, have the same memory size, but the range of their values is different. Okay, nInt and nUInt are native-sized integers in C#. nInt on the 32-bit platforms acts like an int type, and on the 64-bit platforms acts like a long type. And nuInt is similar to nInt, but represents unsigned numbers. So, as you can see, depending on the type of platform, the sizes of these types are different. Alright, with these integral numbers types that C# provides, we have the flexibility to choose the proper type for a specific use case. For example, so far, we used int data type for storing the age of a person, while we could have used byte type instead of int, because the age will not be a negative number or greater than 255. Now, with this change, the memory consumption of this variable is reduced from 32 bits to 8 bits, and this can help conserve memory and improve performance in the large applications. Okay, let's dive into VS Code and show you some examples about integral numbers. Suppose we wanna store the current year in a variable. What type do you think we should use? Okay, based on the value range of integral numbers types, the short type is the proper option for the current year. So, let's say short current year equal 2023. Okay, now we wanna store the population of the US in a variable. Can you guess what data type is proper in this case? Since the population of US is less than 1 billion, the int type is proper option. So, let's say int US population equal 331 million. But what happens if we wanna store the world population in an int variable? Let's try it out. As you can see, because the value range of the int type is less than the population of the world, our code is highlighted in red. Now, let's use the long type instead of int to get rid of this error. Alright, generally, it's important to choose the proper data type for a variable because using a smaller data type than necessary can result in error, while using a larger data type than necessary can waste memory space. Okay, done. See you in the next lecture.